Students and viewers, welcome to e-learning program. So today's topic is algorithms and flowcharts. So if we are going to get started, but let me say at the beginning of the discussion that today we will only look at what algorithm is. So before starting the video, subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon so that you can know about the next video. So, without wasting time, we are started our class today. Student, very first, we are going to explain what is algorithm and flowchart about the short introduction. Algorithm and flowchart are two types of tools to explain the process of a program. That page explains the difference between an algorithm and a flowchart. And how to create a flowchart and to explain an algorithm in a visual way. Algorithm and flowchart are the two different tools used for creating a new program. Especially in computer programming, an algorithm is a step-by-step analysis of the process, while a flowchart explaining the step-by-step program in a graphical way. So it's a very clear. Algorithm and flowchart, these are two kinds of things we are used in a program. Algorithm used for step by step is a reasoning process, and flowchart is a graphical representation for step by step analysis the process while you can use on the program in a graphical way. Next, what is an algorithm? To write a logical step-by-step method to solve the problem is called algorithm. In other words, an algorithm is a procedure for solving problem. In order to solve a mathematical or computer problem, this is the first step of the procedure. An algorithm includes calculation, reasoning, and the data processing. Algorithm can be presented by natural languages, genuine codes, and flowcharts. So this is the very simple and very prominent way we can say that is a definition of an algorithm. Next point of which is characteristic of a good algorithm. First point, an algorithm should be precisely defined. Second, it should clearly mention the input taken. What is meaning of the input taken? We have taken value from the user or from the keyboards. So that things should be clearly mentioned the input taken. Third point, should produce valid inputs. Should have the permission to handle error or wrong input. And last points, should be presentable. The language used should not be too informal. So these are the characteristics of an algorithm. Like say we have discussed few examples. I have declared one questions. Write an algorithm to input 3 subject marks and calculate the total marks percentage of a student. What do we do here? We take 3 subject marks and calculate the total marks percentage of a student. So we can also find out the total marks of the 3 subjects and find out the percentage. So what will be the steps now follow? First step, input 3 subjects like subject 1, subject 2 and subject 3. You can also write like a variable SUB1, SUB2 and SUB3. And next, after input the value of a variable, we can add the 3 subjects SUB plus SUB2 plus SUB3. The total numbers are stored in tray calculate total. And how to find out the percentage. So total, that is a formula of find out the percentage, because three subjects, so total full marks of subject 300 and individual subject marks is 100. So what is the formula to find out the percentage? Total divided by 300, that means 1, 2, 3, so make equal 300 into 100, because the individually marks of each subject, or we can find out a percentage, so in multiply by 100. So percentage after calculated, and then print both values, the total using a print statement. So give the total marks, it will be displayed here, and print the value of total marks. It is called total because I have using here total. Store the final value in a total. So we have write the variables here because we are defining a, here we can show the value of the total marks. And last statement, percentage for use here is a per. Similarly, we can write here page statement and write here percentage, and that's the per. We have stored the percentage just to reach here variable. So that is very easy to write the algorithm of a given program. So this is the question, and that is the answer how we can solve through the process of algorithm. Now we are going for see another example. Example number 2. Write an algorithm, input an age of a person, and whether he is an ex-voter, voter, and non-voter. First, you understand what we will do and how to write this algorithm here. So, just you have to input first a person age. It means that input by input a number which is the age of a person, and after we check whether it is an ex-voter, voter, and non-voter. That means we can compare the person is actually voter, ex-voter, or non-voter. That is multiple condition present here, and we can check the condition according to the criteria, but this criteria is not written here. We can use in our own criteria and find out these three things, ex-voter, voter, and so first of all, we have input our age from the user. Now first we have to input age from the user. Second step, after age, what will be the age? I have put in here ages like 40. Okay, ages 40. I have input 40. And this 40 age is a voter, ex-voter, or non-voter. So obviously we have to our own criteria use in this algorithm. So here the first condition I have given, if age greater than equals 60, first that age, if greater than equals 60, then will be print a ex-voter. So that means I have input age 40. So that means this condition will be false. That means age is 40. So 40 is not greater than 60. So that statement will be not executed because this is a false statement. Okay. Now we are going to the else part. Here we can say to check if it is a voter or not. If else, because if is a first condition and then second condition. So that means if you mark true, so again it false, and false, really false, so again is the next condition. So you can use it if here. Age, it means is 40. Age is greater than 80, obviously. That 40 is greater than 80. So that condition is true. So automatically both are in the frame. And that both condition, that means these both conditions are not matched. So automatically coming here, that is else part, that is a non-voter. So that is a very defined scale I have written here, so we can understand how to a multiple condition use algorithms, and like ex-voter, voter, and voter.
Now if process we can use as an algorithm, any types of number we can input at the age of a person, so that can also evaluate it through the program. So that is the structure and that is a step-by-step process we can follow of when we have to write. Next example, input two numbers and print the greatest value or greatest number. So here also we can input two numbers, that means two values we have to input, and after print which is the greatest value. Okay, so what process to write this algorithm? First, we ask the number, we can store the two numbers from the user. So input two numbers. I have taken two values, NO and NO1. Okay, that is the two values I have taken. And check which number is greater than. So that is, we can use the conditional statement. So if a number is greater than NO1, so that means true part will be executed, this part will be executed, so greatest number is NO. And NO will be not greater than from NO1. So obviously that going to the else part and greatest value number is NO1. Okay. Now students, I am saying a little more clearly. Like numbers, first number we have to write 4 and second number we have to write 7. Okay. So here we can see that NO is 4 and second number is 7. So that means if condition are executed, and that condition will be false because 4 means NO is not greater than NO1 is 7. So automatically else part will be executed. This part will not executed because condition is not matched. So that is the state. And if you write here 40 and here 7, so automatically this statement and these conditions will be true, and this statement is not executed and executed process. I hope students you are got it very clearly. So thank you for watching.